In this tutorial, we'll show you how to add custom dimensions to features in Enterprise Planning Cloud. When you first enable features during business process configuration, you can add custom dimensions. You must define all custom dimensions the first time you enable features for each of the business processes. You cannot define custom dimensions later. However, for the financials business process, you can incrementally associate custom dimensions with additional features after you first enable features. When you run the enable process, custom dimensions are automatically added to forms and rules for features to which the custom dimension applies. Begin by navigating to the Configure page for financials. Select Enable Features. Select the predefined drivers, categories, and options that you want to use. For more information on configuration, please refer to the Help Center. In the Map Rename Dimensions section, you can add custom dimensions. Some custom dimensions, such as product and services and financials, are provided by default in the out-of-the-box framework. These can be renamed and mapped to existing dimensions. For financials, you can also enable three additional custom dimensions. Because we need to track, plan, and analyze product sales, I'll associate the product custom dimension with the revenue feature. You can associate each custom dimension to the appropriate base feature. The other available features are expense, balance sheet, and cash flow. Next, I'll add a custom market dimension to further categorize locations for product sales and associate it with revenue. Note, when you create a custom dimension, there cannot be an existing member with the same name in any other dimension. In this example, I created a custom dimension named Market in Financials, so there cannot be a member named Market in any other dimension. I will also add a Cost Center custom dimension and associate it with Expense to enable it for expense planning. When you are done adding custom dimensions, run the Enable process. To see the enabled features, sign out and sign back in again. Navigate to the Application Overview, select Dimensions, and select the Financials Cube to see the changes. Here are the custom dimensions we added during the Enable Features process. If I return to Configuration and select Enable Features, notice that while you must map, rename, and enable custom dimensions when you first enable the business process, you can incrementally associate custom dimensions with additional base features after you first enable financials. Now let's take a look at the layout of one of the financial forms loaded during the enable process. Notice that the custom dimensions are automatically added to the forms for financials. Custom dimensions are added to the page in forms for features to which the custom dimension applies. In this example, the market and product custom dimensions are applicable to revenue only, so they appear on the page for revenue forms. When custom dimensions are associated with other features, such as cost center to expense in this example, no member for the custom dimension appears on the POV. By contrast, if we look at an expense form, cost center appears on the page and market and product appear on the POV. Now, let's inspect business rules for financials. The custom dimensions are automatically added to the business rules for financials. You can add custom dimensions to other business processes using the same steps. I'll configure workforce and select the predefined drivers, categories, and options I want to use. Here are the predefined custom dimensions for workforce. You can map existing dimensions to workforce dimensions and rename the dimensions. You can add up to three additional custom dimensions. I'll add a project custom dimension. This will allow seamless integration between the workforce and project's business processes. I'll enable features. If we take a look at a workforce form, we can see that the project custom dimension was automatically added. If we take a look at the business rules for workforce, we can see that the project custom dimension was automatically added. For capital, there are two predefined custom dimensions. You can add three more custom dimensions. Because our company needs to integrate capital and projects so we can perform project-based capital planning, I am adding a custom project dimension in capital. I'll also add a funding source custom dimension to determine where money is coming from and the funds available per resource. Similar to the other business processes, after I enable features, the custom dimensions are automatically added to the capital forms and business rules. For projects, you can enable the predefined custom dimensions, program, vendor, or phases, all of which can be renamed and mapped to an existing dimension. Program is added as an attribute dimension. You can also add one additional custom dimension. In this example, I'll enable program and phases and rename phases to stages. Similar to the other business processes we looked at earlier, the custom dimensions are automatically added to project forms and business rules. In this tutorial, you saw how to add custom dimensions to features in Enterprise Planning Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.